And today I will be giving you some homework regarding the chemistry. Some problems, I'll be just giving you some problems. Okay, so homework. Fine, guys. So motion in a plane. First thing, I'll tell you what is entrance question that will be asked in this. Once session is over, you can ask me all the doubts. Whatever doubts in the topic or outside topic, you can ask me when session is over. First thing, I'll tell you what is the very important question which will be asked for an entrance examination. Okay, so you should know that that question will come for you in entrance respectively. Okay, so motion in a plane. This is our topic today. I'm gonna teach So I think everyone has come now. So I think better I'll start the class. Or else we'll go in order. That's perfect, I think. So we'll go in order. So is there anyone who does not know what is scalar and a vector? Scalar quantity and vector quantity. Is there anyone who does not know what is scalar and vector here? I just wanted to know. See. But anyway, I'll give you something. Okay. Scalar means only magnitude is there. Vector, magnitude with direction, magnitude and direction. Correct. And what is the example of scalar? Let's take our own weight. Is weight vector or scalar? The weight. Everyone answer me this thing. Vector. How many of you are saying it's a vector? Weight. I'm not asking about mass, okay? I'm asking about weight. What about Rishabh and Karthik? What is your answer? So it's a, okay. It is a vector quantity. Weight is a vector quantity. How do we identify vector quantity? First thing, magnitude. Correct? Magnitude is there in both the things. Direction, and then one more thing is what? Unit. The one is direction, and one more thing is what? Unit. You got the point. So vector can be completely specified by or completely described by magnitude, unit and direction respectively. But what about mass? Mass, time, temperature, length. Length, mass, temperature, correct, electric current, energy, speed, everything is what? Scalar. No need to worry. Okay, speed. But what about displacement? Displacement is again a vector quantity. Displacement, acceleration, momentum, lot of things are vector quantity. Fine. So no need for you to worry in this. This can be asked for a one mark question, that's all. But regarding the entrance point of view, we have to understand each and everything very clearly. So there is a big confusion for all of us. Okay, I'll draw that thing. One is mass and weight. Correct? There will be a confusion. Okay, how is this mass a scalar quantity and how is weight vector quantity, especially in our entrance examination. Correct? I told you weight is what? Weight is a vector. How? If we can define the weight, what is weight? Weight is the, I will write in different pen. Yeah. Weight is the force with which a body is attracted towards the center of earth. And also the weight, it varies from place to place. Correct? Our weight varies from place to place. But let's take about mass. Mass is nothing but quantity of matter. Anything which occupies space and has called mass is called matter. So it is a quantity of matter. And mass, what is mass? Mass remains constant. Mass remains constant. We will say something like mass of an electron. Okay. We won't say weight of an electron, because weight will vary from place to place. So if you go this detail into the minute thing, okay, the most minute thing, then we will be able to crack any entrance examination. Clear?
Yeah.
Are you clear now? So kindly note down this thing. This is an additional information which is not there in your textbook. If you're able to understand this thing, so what is weight actually? What is weight? If someone, again, if you have got doubt, okay, I will do one more thing. What is our weight? Mass into gravity. That's it. W is equal to mg. W is equal to mg. Again, if you're getting difficulty in this, draw this triangle. Draw this triangle. Put this thing. Put W and mg on the top. W is mass into gravity, acceleration due to gravity. Clear? If you finished this thing, let me know. I think it should be clear. It should be clear now. Because more than this detail, you can't find it in book also. Even if you search in your NCERT book, you cannot find this detail or clear. Fine. If you note down these things, because it's very important for us to understand the thing, okay. Because hardly we get around 180 questions. Fine. If you are getting 180 questions in entrance, and each day, if you are able to solve at least one question, or else each class, if you are able to do at least one question, then can't we get this 180 questions all correct? Simple as that. That's it. Fine. Only once everyone is done, I'll go to the next page. Okay. Yeah. Just say if you're done, just message me done. And then I'll go to the next thing. Very important things for us to learn. Perfect. representation of a vector. So these things are just for your board exam thing. Okay. The one which I'm going to represent now. How do you represent a vector? So A. Okay, then I'll just draw this line. So what does this mean? The starting point, this point, which one? The one with the black dot here. This starting point is called tail. The ending point is called what? Or the end of this arrow line. End of this arrow line is called what? Head respectively, tail and head. Fine. So how do I represent this thing? I'll write AB. Correct. I'll write AB. Then I'll put this arrow. And for magnitude, what I'll put for magnitude symbol, I will put this particular thing. For this is called what? My magnitude. This is our magnitude symbol. Fine. So for vector, I will put what? AB vector. And these two lines represents magnitude. That's all. And magnitude is always positive. That's called modulus of a vector. This symbol is called not only magnitude, but also modulus. Or modulo, you can tell. Or module, whatever you want to say. Modulus, module, or anything you can tell for this. Finished? I think everyone has done it. Simple thing. And why we are studying this chapter, or why we are studying vector chapter? Let's take our cinema industry. Okay. Cinema industry, we all hear about what? 100 crore movie, 150 crore movie, Avatar. Correct? The highest grossing film. Okay, not now anyway. Now the Avengers. Avengers has crossed. Avengers Endgame. Has everyone seen Avengers Endgame here? Is there anyone who did not see Avengers Endgame movie? You have seen the movie. Yes. Everyone has seen this thing? The 3D movie I'm talking about. Because Avengers Endgame and what we're going to study now, there is a relationship. That's the reason. Has everyone seen a 3D movie? Correct? Yeah. So in 3D movie, what is the main thing? Some objects appears to come closer to us. So why we are studying this vector? Why we are studying this 3D, which is not there in your NCERT book or anything I'm going to tell you now. Okay, the only thing why I am taking this session, okay, is to make sure that you guys can do things on your own. 3D printers. Okay, one of the applications is 3D printer. 3D camera. 3D printers, 3D camera. All use vectors. All use vectors. How does some objects come closer to us? By using a vector called position vector. Because only if you know these things, then only you will understand how much important is this chapter. Okay, position vector. For example, I'll just draw two vectors for you guys, okay? This is a vector, one vector I've drawn here. Then one more vector I'll draw somewhere like this. Fine. So suppose I'm naming these are all A vector, B vector, and R vector. And this is O, or whatever it is, not required. Which has got the highest length in this? A, B, or R? Which vector has got the highest length in this? R, correct? R vector has got the highest length, or it is the highest line segment, I can tell. Everyone agree? Yes. So this R vector, or whichever has got the highest length, that is called our position vector. So now again, we can see about the new iPhone 11 Pro or the OnePlus 8 Pro, correct? I don't know how many of you follow mobile phones. Okay, so through all of this stuff, they're saying that 48 megapixel, 12 megapixel, correct? How are all of these camera designed? And one more thing, in camera, if you zoom, okay, you can find some grids actually. Grids. Has everyone seen any grid in any camera? Here, grids. Because I want to make sure that you understand each and everything. No, I'll show you one thing. One second. Let me just take my camera thing. Okay. I'm just clicking one photo. Fine. I'll just open my Excel. One second, guys. I'm going to click one thing. Not the Excel grid, okay. Not the Excel grid I'm talking about. Fine. I'll just. So guys, now I'm sharing a photo to all of your mobiles. Okay, I'm just sharing a photo to all of your mobiles now. Just check your mobile now itself. Just check your mobile, guys, now. Just check the photo in the mobile. Did you see, I think, Karthik, please check your mobile. Adi, you also. Can you just zoom in that picture? Can you just zoom in it? Can you see some not proper lines or something like that? Can you see some irregularity into that particular thing? If you can zoom in the pic, yeah. I think Karthik, can you just take your phone? I just send it actually to you. I'm just waiting for you. So the end result is, okay, while designing the camera or while designing any of these electronic goods, especially the camera thing, fine. We use what? The help of position vectors. That is what I will tell you. Suppose in future, if you want to build things, then you have to use this stuff, position vector, for designing those cameras and everything. Fine. Are you clear, guys, now? Did you understand the importance of position vector? No one will tell you this is the position vector. They'll just teach you R vector is equal to something. Okay. If you want, I can just join this stuff. They'll just tell you something and they'll just say it's a position vector. It determines the position. But what is this position vector? No one will tell you. Okay. So everyone is clear up to this? I hope everyone is clear. Next thing, tensors. not sensor, it is tensors. Tensors are nothing but they are neither scalar nor vector. Okay, they are neither scalar nor vector. I'll tell you an example for tensor. These are all not there in the book, but make can come in entrance. Stress. Is my stress same as your stress? Stress. No, right? Stress is something which can change, and the amount of magnitude also can change. Correct. So tensors, please note on this thing. It is neither scalar or nor vector. Example: stress, moment of inertia. Stress is fine. One example is more than enough. I just gave you one more. Please note on this thing. Done. Okay, perfect. Fine. So the next important thing for you is unit vector. Unit vector, okay? Fine. So first I am representing a vector in this. Unit vector is nothing but n cap. N cap, this is called cap symbol, is equal to n vector by mod n vector. Okay, n cap is nothing but what? N vector by mod n vector. Kindly draw this thing, because this is there in your class 12th also. Very important chapter, okay, and I'll explain each and everything. No need to worry. Just blindly note down this formula. Blindly, I will explain you what is what in each and everything by using a problem. Now, in the problem, you will get like find the unit vector. Find the unit vector of n cap is equal to I cap plus j cap plus k cap. So you might be wondering, what is this I, j, n, k? I will draw that also. So before that, scalar and vector, I have to tell you one more difference. Scalar. Scalar meaning what? There is something called dot product. Vector is called cross product. Again, you might be thinking, what is this dot product or cross product? For example, work is equal to force into displacement, FD. Whereas torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance. Here, see the symbol which I used. This is cross symbol, multiplication symbol, cross product. Whereas this is dot product. Till now, you have seen is what? A dot B and A cross B are same. Correct? Till now. But actually, dot and cross has got its own physical meaning. That is the next step which I'm gonna teach you. What is the physical meaning of this? Dot product meaning FD cos theta will come. Cross product meaning D stands for displacement, okay, or distance, whatever it is. FD sin theta will come. So sin theta is coming for which one? The cross product. Dot product, what is coming? Cos theta. Correct? And scalars are normally one dimensional, but vectors are either 2D or 3D. Scalars are mostly one dimensional. How many of you are seeing this for the first time? So dot product is this thing, cross product. Work is equal to F dot D, torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance, FD sin theta. This is 1D and this is either 2D or 3D. Plane is a 2D. Okay. So the most important thing for this is when to use cos theta if it is scalar, when to use sin theta if it is vector. Fine. So I hope everyone has written down this thing. Now I have to tell you a very important thing. This is just a basic thing and very important also. Draw the circle. Okay. Then mark down. I cap, J cap and K cap. I cap, J cap and K cap. For dot product, what is the first heading? For dot product. And this is all in clockwise direction. I hope everyone know what is clockwise. See the clock? That's it. Clockwise direction. If you don't know clockwise direction, just see the clock. That's it. You'll get to know what is it. Dot product in the sense I dot I equal to 1. J dot J equal to 1. K dot K equal to 1. Whereas I cap, this is I cap dot J cap is equal to 0. Or J cap dot K cap is equal to 0. Or if it is different element, then it is 0. Are you clear now? This is dot product. Now, if I want cross product, dot is done. Now, next is cross product. Same diagram only I am following. Okay, the same diagram. Okay, the same diagram I am following. I cross I is 0. J cross J is 0. K cross K is 0. And next thing is I cross J. This is important for us. Okay, this is important for us. I cross J is K. J cross K is I. Whereas if I just put I cross K, in anti-clockwise direction, it is minus j. That's it. It is minus j. Yeah, is everyone able to, is my voice audible to everyone now? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, perfect. So what I am telling you in this is, kindly follow what I say. No need for any doubt or anything. Whatever is there for exam, I will be teaching you that thing. Okay, whatever is there or whichever questions they can ask you, I will teach you those questions, and even I will teach you what is required. I dot I is equal to 1. This is for dot product. And j dot j is equal to 1. Rest everything for dot is 0. K dot k is equal to 1. But if I write I dot j, it is 0. If I write j dot I, again it is 0. Fine. So whichever is important for us, I will teach you. No need for you to worry in anything. Fine. This is cross product. Next is cross product is what? Everything is in clockwise direction. Clockwise direction. I cross J is equal to K. J cross I. J cross I is not in clockwise, it is in anti-clockwise. So that is minus K. Simple thing. Next one. J cross K. J cross K is I. What about K cross I? That is also J. I'll write neatly this thing. Okay. K cross J, this is my J, is equal to I itself. Is it correct? Is my K cross J is equal to I or minus I? To everyone in the chat, is my K cross J is equal to I or minus I? Yes, it is minus I. Very good. Because it is in anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise, that's all. Simple thing, anti-clockwise. Fine. Please note down this thing. Once you note it down, let me know the same. If everyone has said me yes, then I'll go to the next thing. please do not think any other thing, okay? Blindly copy it down. Whatever is required for you for the entrance examination, I'll make sure that it is delivered best for you. Okay, there won't be any compromise in that. Whatever knowledge is to be required for you, I'll make sure that it is given to you properly. Okay, so that you need not worry at all. I think everyone has completed that. So in dot product, only the same terms will give me the answer as one. Currently, there is more than enough. Okay. So if I give you some two vectors, a vector value is 2i cap plus 3j plus 4k. Okay. And b vector value is 4i plus 5j plus 2k. Find me a vector dot b vector value. I need answers from you. Find me a dot b vector. Find me vector a dot vector b. Type your answer in the Zoom chat. Simple thing. So guys, how do we do this thing? I got two answers, but two answers are different. Is there anyone who does not know this thing? Ping me now. If anyone does not know how to do this, ping me now. Kindly do not be afraid. Yeah, I'll tell you this thing. No need to worry. Okay, fine. A dot B. This class is to make sure that to educate you properly. A dot B is what? Write down this thing. 2i plus 3j plus 4k. Correct? Only keep one thing in mind. This is dot product. What product? This is dot product. 4i plus 5j plus 2k. What I told in dot product? This is 2i into 4i. Correct? What is 2 into 4? What is I dot I value in dot product? 1. So what is the answer? 2 into 4, what is it? 8. But what happened if I take this 2 into this 5? What is I dot j value? 0. Correct? So only I have to multiply similar things. So 2i, this is fine. Next thing is what? 3 and 5. 3 and 5, what is the answer for us? 3 5 is 15. Correct? Next thing is what? 4 and 2. 4 2 is 8. So what is the answer? 16 plus 15 is 31 is the answer. Yes. 31 is the answer. Now is everyone clear now? First thing is I want you to try. Okay, if you are not getting it, definitely I'll help you out. These are all my made up questions. Okay, these are all the made up questions. Please do not get afraid about these things. These are all LKG level stuffs. Because now only we are learning about vectors and scalars and everything. Correct. So this is from scratch. This is an LKG level simple multiplication. That's all. And they will definitely give either dot product or cross product. Okay, still now I not come to this cross product. Fine, no need to worry. So Karthik, did you understand? And Adi, both of you got it? Karthik and Adi. Yes. How to remember these things? How to remember these things? Next question for us. Because in 12, these kind of things won't be there. Okay. This is especially for the NEET aspirants. If you are going to take the NEET, it is physics, chemistry, and biology. Correct? And what we are discussing now, this is max in physics. You see, any teacher who is taking you physics won't go the detail which I am doing it now. Because I take here the PCM, physics, chemistry, and max. And there is no teacher in India who takes all physics, chemistry, and max entrance. I'm not talking about the tuitions, okay? I'm talking about the entrance examination. There is not even a single teacher in India, I can tell proudly, who takes all these three subjects by himself or herself for entrance. So, which means I can relate. Correct? So, how to get a rank in NEET without doing math? Because all these things, integration, differentiation, everything will come for the entrance thing. Okay, but in physics and limited quantities, it will come. But we have to make sure that each and every minute detail, okay, it is not like our 10th standard or 9th standard stuff. Every minute detail, we should be thorough to get the rank number one. That should be our goal. Okay. So what is my next thing? How to remember this stuff? Make questions. That's it. How do we remember this stuff? Make questions. So what you have to do is, A vector is 2i plus 3j. Okay. And B vector is, I'm giving only k. Now, what is find A dot B? Find A dot B. This is a question which I'm giving you. Correct? So, what do you do? 2i plus 3j into k cap. Is there I vector in this? No. Is there J vector in this? No. Zero. Clear? Is everyone clear about this? So I want you guys to make two questions each by yourself and send me the answer in WhatsApp. Send me the question and the answer, both the things, in WhatsApp. So I need only two questions. Okay. Yeah. Two questions you make it. This is the only place to make sure that you are thorough in this. And today I will be sending you a PDF of chemistry in the last class, some questions with the answer. Write it as an assignment and send it to me. Okay. So this I am expecting you from now. So I'm just verifying all your answers. Let me see. So guys, while talking about entrance or anything, what we need speed. Okay, that is the thing. If your answer is wrong or not, then I'm not least bothered. How much competitive you are, that's what I am looking for. Let me see. I'm just checking all of your answers clearly. Let's see that. And always make easy questions. Okay, do not make any questions which are confusing to you. Okay, do not do that. Fine, because the idea of making question is what? For you to remember for a long time, not to impress the teacher. Normally what we do, we submit the assignment on time. We do all the homeworks properly and everything, correct? But for entrance preparation, it is not like that. We have to do it for ourselves. We have to put that extra effort. That is for me. Okay, not for me, for you actually. You have to think in your own mind saying that it is for me, I am putting this extra effort. Okay, and if you have got any doubts in that, okay, if you got any doubts in this, feel free to ask me the same. I'm always here to help you out. Give me a call. Okay, fine. If you got any doubt anytime, you should give me a call in my number. Fine. Then I will help you out immediately. Physics, chemistry, or max, any priority. Okay. Call me, not biology. Okay. Biology, I'll be able to help you out. Okay, but still I'm telling you. Fine. Physics, chemistry, or max, anything is there, you please feel free to reach out to me first. Clear? Okay. And then the next question is our n cap or n vector. Correct? Up to this now, everyone is clear? I hope everyone is clear. Let us do the n cap or n vector. Here, n vector is given as what? 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 4k cap. Find unit vector. Find unit vector is the question. Okay, 1 second, my battery got over in the pen. Let me just change it. Find the unit vector. How do we do it? First step for you guys is what? Formula used. What is the formula in this? N cap, this is my cap, okay? This symbol is my cap. N cap is equal to N vector by mod N vector. Put it in a box. Put it in a box. N vector, write it like that itself. This implies n vector is what? Like this itself, 2i plus 3j plus 4k divided by what is mod of n meaning? Mod of n meaning root of square of those values. Root of square of 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. Root of square of 2 square plus 3 square plus 4 square. That's all. So what is this? 2 square 4 plus 9, 13. 13 plus 16, that is root 29. 2i plus 3j plus 4k. That is the only reason I told you. This is a very below level. Simple addition, squaring, multiplication. or class 5th or class 6th we are doing. That's it. Class 5th or class 6th we are doing. That's it. Yes. This is by root and mean. Is everyone clear in this? Modulus meaning root of square of these values. What is modulus meaning? Root of square of those values. Root of square and add everything of those values. Now are you clear? Everyone is clear with this? Any doubt to anyone up to this, they can ask me now. Only up to what I taught you. Okay, what I taught you. Not any other thing. Any doubt on anything up to now? And this is my 9. Okay, I'll just write it down clearly. Root 29. Only up to what I have taught you now. Unit vector is there. Position vector. Whatever I taught you, is there anything which you did not understand? Other doubts after the end of the session. Okay, that I will. All other doubts after the end of the session. Okay, all other doubts I will be answering after the end of the session. So Krish, what is your doubt? Where we had write coordinates and position vectors given? Is that your doubt? So Krish, that question will never ever come. First thing I'm telling you. Okay. Those things, they are called coordinate ratio. Okay. Or cosine ratio and everything that I will be explaining in detail. Fine. You got the point. So those things I'll be explaining it. So currently you're asking me a question which I'm still about to explain. Okay, the coordinate thing and everything I will explain you in detail in the coming sessions. Okay. That is called direction ratio and direction cosine is there. Fine. That I don't want to teach you now itself. If I teach you everything in a one shot, that is not the right way to learn. That's whatever you're asking is called direction ratio and direction cosine, and I don't want to discuss it further. Okay, you can just search it, direction ratio and direction cosine, if you want. So guys, any other doubt is there for anyone till what I taught today? If there is no doubt, you can tell me no doubt. No doubt. Fine. So except Adi and Krish, both of you can leave the session. Okay, Adi and Krish, please stay back. Okay, Rishabh and Karthik, you can leave the session. And to Rishabh and Karthik and to everyone, I'll be sending you the PDF. Okay, in your WhatsApp number, I'll be sending you the PDF. Please do that. Okay, please do that. So Adi and Krish, you can stay back. others can leave the session.